physics class 9 chapter 1st motion when a body is said to be in motion when it changes its position continuously with respect to a stationary object taken as a reference point. Physical quantity, the quantity which can be measured is called physical quantity. Physical quantities are of two types, scalar quantity and vector quantity. Scalar quantity is the quantity which have magnitude only and have no direction are called scalar quantities. Examples: mass, distance, time, speed. Vector quantity, the quantity which have both direction and as well as magnitude are called vector quantities. Examples: displacement, velocity, acceleration, force. And distance and displacement. Distance, the length of path covered by a moving body at any time is called distance. The length of path covered by a moving body is called distance. Distance is a scalar quantity, its unit is meter. It can never be zero. And displacement, it is a displacement, the shortest distance between the final and initial position of a moving body is called displacement. It is a vector quantity, it may be zero. And speed, non-uniform motion and uniform motion. Then when a body covers equal distances in equal time intervals, it's called uniform motion. And when the body covers unequal distances in equal time intervals, then it is called non-uniform motion. Speed and velocity. Speed, we will define speed first. The total distance traveled in a unit time interval is called speed. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Its unit is meter per second. It is denoted by small b. It is a scalar quantity. And velocity is the total velocity, total displacement traveled to the in a unit time interval is called velocity. Velocity is equal to total displacement upon total time. Its unit is meter per second. It is a vector quantity. And acceleration, rate of change of velocity of a body is called acceleration. Acceleration is a vector quantity. Its unit is meter per second square. And it is denoted by small a. A is equal to, means acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time taken for change. That is, A is equal to B minus U upon T. Here B is the final velocity and U is the initial velocity and T is the time taken for change, A is the acceleration. When the magnitude of a body is increasing with time, magnitude of velocity is increasing with time, then the acceleration is positive. And when the magnitude of velocity is decreasing with time, then the acceleration is negative, and negative acceleration is known as retardation. Acceleration is zero when the velocity of the object remains constant, means velocity doesn't change. Now acceleration, speed, distance, displacement, velocity, motion, finished. Scalar vector also finished. Now equations of motion. First equation of motion is b is equal to u plus at, means final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration into time. And second equation of motion is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Here s is the distance and u is the initial velocity and t is the time, u into t plus 1 by 2 into acceleration into time, means time square. And third equation of motion is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. V square means square of the final velocity is equal to u square plus 2as, means square of the initial velocity plus 2 into a is acceleration, s is the distance.